Figure it out?
Not Deidre or Nicholas. There was an empty gas can just sitting out front, and Bill, well, he was mowing the damn lawn.
Bill!
I'm Christopher Smith, film critic for the Bangor Daily News, and this is The Crazies.
How long has he been playing a statue? A
couple hours now.
Hey, Ben.
All things wise and wonderful.
From director Breck Eisner, by way of George Romero's 1973 classic horror movie of the same name, the film follows a husband and wife in a small Midwestern town. There they find themselves battling for survival as their friends and family descend into madness. What's causing it? A mysterious toxin in the water supply that turns everyone exposed to it into mindless killers. Via satellite, Eisner and his cast agreed to speak about the movie, and they offered this.
What The Crazies does, which I really enjoy about this movie, is that anyone in town could be infected with this disease and you don't know it. And it could be your wife, it could be your husband, it could be your best friend, it could be your mother, your father, your kid, anybody who happens to have consumed the water at the wrong time can get this disease and slowly becomes mad.
I really like the idea of a couple sort of going through this thing together, and the fact that they were pregnant and just sort of codependent in that way, and just the stress that places on a relationship and how they kind of escape together. I like the togetherness of it.
It's being brought up to date. The budget that they had for the original was small. There's only so much you can do. But in terms of subject matter and how it's approached, it's somewhat similar, but we're really kicking it into the 21st century, so to speak.
By the way, and I don't mean to make light of this because it sounds like I'm being, but I love the title. I couldn't get enough of the title. Yeah. Days after I read it, I kept thinking, Crazies. I don't know, sounds cool. Sounds like something I want to see. The Crazies.
Remakes of horror movies can be questionable at best. See The Wolfman for a prime recent example. But if the film is as successful as Zack Snyder's remake of Romero's Dawn of the Dead, then The Crazies might just offer a nice surprise. The film opens this Friday, February 27th, where it promises to wash away the competition.
Let's go! Let's go!
I'm Christopher Smith, film critic for the Bangor Daily News, and that's your look at The Crazies.